What do you think, then?
I don't know. Mum's bought her a jigsaw puzzle.
A jigsaw puzzle? She's only a year old.
Apparently, it's 18 months plus, and Mum is convinced that her granddaughter is a genius.
Well?
You watch out. It'll be the Children's Encyclopedia Britannica next.
I think it should be more fun than educational.
Yeah, I think you're right. It should be fun. Oh, what about that baby swing?
Yeah, it'll be December. She won't be able to use it for months.
I suppose livestock's out of the question.
If you're talking about a puppy, then the answer is absolutely yes. It is out of the question.
Well, I was thinking more of a budgie.
Yeah, well, that includes budgies, mice, hamsters, or anything else feathery, furry, or scaly.
Well, we don't want anything scaly, do we?
Oh, I don't know. One thing I do know is we have to get some sherry for Santa and the reindeer.
Well, the reindeer drinks sherry.
You see, you obviously haven't seen my reindeer outfit.
I think your mummy's gone mad.
Hey, gorgeous.
How do you know what all the girls call me?
Call it a lucky guess.
What can I do for you at this time of the morning?
I can think of plenty of things, but not while you're at the other end of a phone. It is my day off, and I was wondering if you want to do something. You know, make a day of it. You don't want to?
Well, I'd love to.
But?
But I'm just off night shift, and I need to get my head down for a couple of hours.
So we meet for lunch? The Icon about 12:15?
Yeah, I'll be there. Sweet dreams.
You bet. See ya.
Bye.
Hello, darling. Not here, Mum.
Darling, what have you been up to, Lucy?
What time did you get up to do this? You were supposed to wait for me.
5:30, I couldn't wait.
But, darling... Kirsty, you're meant to be taking things easy, not rushing around in the middle of the night doing DIY.
I wanted it to be perfect for when Eddie arrives.
You'll wear yourself out.
I'm fine. Never better in my life. Not long now. It's pretty good. I've got the whole house ready. Do you think he'll like it?
He'll love it.
Yes. Yes, he will. No, at least this room's ready. That's all that matters.
Why don't you want her to have a doll? A pedal car? What would she want a pedal car for, Ronnie? I'm not gender stereotyping.
Darling, you've got enough here for an army of babies.
I know, I got a bit carried away.
I think you're going to need more cupboard space.
Just think, Mum. This time next year, we'll be choosing the baby's first Christmas presents. I really can't wait.
They grow up so quickly, darling. Don't try and rush it.
The baby will want a picture of its daddy.
What's that look for? I'm just a little concerned you haven't told him before now. You're nearly 5 months, darling.
I've done the right thing, Mum. Eddie would have worried himself silly stuck at sea knowing I was pregnant, doing a house move from Portsmouth to Leatherbridge on my own.
Well, that's another thing. With your history, you should never have done a house move on your own.
Will you stop worrying? What Eddie and I have, this marriage, is nothing like my first one, Mum.
I know.
There aren't going to be any miscarriages because of terrible arguments and all the stress I had with John. Eddie's so different.
And have you registered with the doctor?
The Mill Health Centre. It's one of the reasons I chose this house. Surgery just around the corner.
Good. And how did your antenatal visit go? Well, Kirsty, you have been for your antenatal visit. Kirsty!
I just want to do it with Eddie. Two of us together. Make it really special.
Anyone home?
Kirsty?
Don't run, darling.
Eddie?
Kirsty?
Oh, I love you.
Me too. Come with me.
Yeah? What? What is it? What is it? Pleased.
More than pleased. What is it? Are you angry that I haven't told you before now? Is it the house? Don't you like it? This is what we planned, isn't it? A baby.
Whose is it? The baby. Who's the father?
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells.
Well, that's a simple enough question, isn't it? Who is the father of that?
Please don't say things like that. This is our child.
No.
Our baby.
No.
Yes. The baby was conceived on your last shore leave.
Oh, was it really?
Yes. Yes, it was. I'm just 5 months. I can have a scan, prove it. I can't believe I'm having to say all of this.
And I can't believe I'm having to ask you. I would have done anything for you. Anything.
Why would you think I've been unfaithful? I love you. We love each other. Eddie! Eddie! Stop! Darling!
Eddie! Help her!
Let me see.
Leave me alone.
Let me see.
Leave me alone.
Oh, darling. Now see what you've done.
Kirsty, come on.
Yeah, thanks. And a Merry Christmas to you too. Wouldn't like to have his head in the morning. Actually, I wouldn't like to have it now.
keep still, or you will do some damage.
Do you care?
Well, you know I care.
Talk to me. I don't understand. Why are you being like this?
I've phoned the health centre and the doctor's already on her way. I hope you're pleased with yourself. She doesn't need you to behave like her first husband.
Don't, Mum.
But you could lose the
thing. Don't even say it. There was no need to call the doctor.
Yes, there was. You've had 3 miscarriages. There was every need.
You hadn't.
Darling, when I told the receptionist about your history and that you'd had a fall, she said a doctor would come out straight away. A Dr. Woodson.
Shouldn't bother people.
Jean's right. You need to be checked up.
Please, Eddie. I really need you.
What is wrong with you? How can you be so heartless?
Sorry, the front door's open. What's been happening here then? Well, I think you've just bruised it, so there's nothing too much to worry about there. Now, what about this pregnancy?
What about it?
It says in your notes you've had 3 previous pregnancies, all ending in miscarriage around the 4th month.
My first marriage.
Right, and your husband?
Eddie. His name's Eddie.
Eddie's discussed IVF treatment with your GP before you left Portsmouth.
Eddie and I, we've been married 2 years. I've been having problems conceiving.
And you're 5 months?
Yes.
Okay, and you've been in Netherbridge for what, approximately 3 weeks? Now, there are no antenatal records in your notes. Do you know why that would be?
I didn't go to my GP. I didn't even begin to dare hope until I missed my 3rd period. By then, the plans for the move were in full swing. And with Eddie being at sea, I was doing it all myself.
I see.
These past 5 months have been his last tour of duty. He's retired from the Navy. We wanted to start a new life here, close to my mum. Eddie doesn't have any family. So I got on with the move. You chose this house. What could that stop me?
It's all right. Take your time.
Couldn't believe I'd fallen pregnant on his last shore leave. How wonderful was that?
And it's not wonderful anymore?
I don't know. I wanted to keep it as a surprise for Eddie. And I was afraid to talk about it to anyone but Mum. Afraid that if I tempted fate, something would go wrong again.
And has it?
It's been a real shock for him. It was the wrong decision to keep it a secret.
I'll go and get you a drink, shall I? Would you stay with her? Kirsty could do with one of those. You must be thrilled. Coming home to discover you're going to be a dad.
Would you like one, Doctor?
Oh, no, I'm okay, thanks. Kirsty tells me you've been trying for a baby for a couple of years now.
It's not mine.
Why would you say that? Is it because you've been away for 5 months? Because I've examined Kirsty and I can assure you she looks anywhere between 4.5 to 5 months pregnant to me. I mean, a scan will give us a definite date.
I only had my grandfather in boarding school when I was a kid. Then the Navy. That's all the family I had. But this, with Kirsty, is all I've ever wanted. Our own family.
And now you've got it, haven't you?
I didn't think the right person existed for me till I met Kirsty. Well, that baby's not mine.
I've been stood up.
What? No, have you really?
Lawrence, say if it wasn't true, Donna.
No, I don't suppose you would. There's nothing to boast about, is it? Oh, no, it's really horrible then that happens, though. Not that it's ever happened to me, but... So, who were you meeting?
Chris?
Well, he's gone to the rugby club.
What? How do you know that?
Greg told me.
What's Greg got to do with it?
Well, nothing. I don't think Greg ever goes to the rugby club.
I mean, how does he know that Chris has gone there?
Oh, I see. So, well, he was coming back from an emergency call about half an hour ago, and he saw Chris going into the clubhouse. But you know what Greg's like? Seeing someone like Chris really brighten up his day, couldn't wait to tell me about it.
I'm going
to
kill him.
Who, Greg?
No, Chris, you idiot.
Oh, well, chime in. No need to take it out on me, Michelle.
We'll take it out on Chris when I see him. What's he going to the rugby club for anyway? He doesn't even play rugby.
Well, you don't have to. They let anyone in. Oh, but I do know that there's a posh Christmas do going on today. Maybe even a celebrity there or something.
You what? Oh, no, seriously, I'm going to kill him. I mean, he could have taken me. Why didn't he take me?
Well, I don't know. Maybe you're not posh enough. Do you want to mix pie? What is it, Doctor?
Nothing. I'd just like to examine you, see what's happening with this pregnancy.
What's happening? What could be happening, Doctor?
There's nothing to worry about. I'm just going to carry out a routine examination.
Everything feels fine.
Yes, and I'm sure everything is fine. It's just, we haven't had any antenatal appointments. So I just like to get an idea of how things are. That's all.
Stay, Mum.
What is it, Doctor?
I've got a baby clinic at the surgery today. One of the midwives will bring in a scanner. I'd like to have the baby scanned.
Is something wrong?
My baby.
It's just a precaution. I wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't get things checked out thoroughly. So if one of you could bring her to the surgery today, I'll make a call and make sure the midwives are there. You won't be in the way. You can come in and be with Kirsty.
Well, I don't know if I can.
This isn't about you right now. Kirsty's gonna need you.
Betty, please come and see. Can you see the baby? Will we be able to see it?
Kirsty, you haven't had a miscarriage.
See, Eddie, see? The doctor says it herself.
No, Kirsty, listen to me. You were never pregnant. There was no baby.
I want you to go, Dr. Woodson. I don't want you here saying these things.
Darling.
Of course I'm pregnant. I haven't had a period for 5 months. I'm starting to show.
Kirsty, love, don't.
I am pregnant!
Darling, please. Please. Look, you have to listen.
No.
Kirsty, sit down. Please.
I'm infertile. can't father a child.
Nonsense. You can't be infertile. Because I haven't been unfaithful. So this is our baby.
Yes, I know you haven't been unfaithful, no. But, Kirsty, you've just got to accept that
no.
There isn't a baby.
No, I don't.
Kirsty, while your husband was away, he had some tests carried out.
No. Why? What sort of tests? You're not ill, are you? You wouldn't tell me.
No, listen. When I was on shore leaving Dubai, I paid to have some tests done. I thought I might be responsible for you not being able to conceive because, I mean, you've managed it before.
No. Our doctor in Portsmouth, he said that the miscarriages could be making it harder for me to conceive. You know he did.
Yes, and the test showed that I don't produce any sperm. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Stop.
I'm so sorry, Kirsty. I'm sorry for all those terrible things I said. They were totally, totally unforgivable. But, Kirsty, I need you to forgive me now.
I've got something to be, Dr. Woodson.
I think you might be experiencing a phantom pregnancy.
You mean I've imagined everything?
No, it's not quite like that. When a woman has longed for a baby like you have, sometimes the body can do strange things. Also, in your case, your scan has shown up some very large fibroids in your uterus.
Well, what are they? Are they dangerous?
No. No, they're benign growths. Women live with them for years, don't even know they've got them.
But not in my case.
Occasionally, they can cause problems. They can make periods more heavy, last longer.
Or me. Harder for women to fall pregnant.
They can affect fertility, making it more difficult to conceive.
Yeah, harder, but not impossible.
No, not impossible. Some people have them removed successfully. I think their presence may be what's causing the swelling in your abdomen.
Well, where do you go from here, Doctor?
I'd like Kirsty to go to St. Phil's for further tests, so I'm going to refer her to a consultant gynecologist.
So there is hope. There is hope that Kirsty could conceive one day. Yes?
Yes. I know it's a lot to take on, but there are other alternatives, like a sperm donor.
Didn't you, Dr. Woods? And you examined me?
I couldn't be sure until I saw the scan.
Thank you, but sort it all out so quickly. Otherwise, we would have gone on thinking of... Well, you know what we were thinking.
You will be okay. Please, don't give up hope. Giant bunny. Ronnie, she's got loads of cuddly toys. You know what I think we should get her for Christmas? Great big hug.
Excuse me. Chris.
Cover blown. Just going to do nothing for my street cred.
Yeah, well, I can only agree with that. You're Santa?
Yeah. Look, I'm really sorry about lunch. My mate Steve, he's organised all of this, and then he couldn't make it.
Right.
Well, he asked me to step in at the last minute, do the Santa thing. I didn't realise how much the kids were going to love him.
Yeah, well, everybody loves Santa.
Anyway, I had to rush out. I missed the present-giving bit. couldn't disappoint my public.
No. No, of course you couldn't.
Where's Santa? Come on, kids, let's get Santa to draw the raffle.
Well, I have to go.
I'll, right here, if that's okay.
You better. Half an hour, I'll be all yours.
Okay.
Come on, Santa!
It was an issue highlighted earlier in the year by Madonna, but what's the real story about foreign adoptions? Fiona Bruce investigates tonight on BBC One at 7:30. Next this afternoon, Fight Fire with Fire in Diagnosis Murder.